we all play games on our phones, and why not? We have got phones with refresh rates and we have got phones with great screens. So we make the most out of it, right? And apart from that, we use it for navigation a lot. And that is when we get this problem, which is known as overheating. And we face that a lot, but we cannot stop gaming, right? Or for that matter of fact, we cannot stop looking for destinations through maps, can we? No, right? Then what to do? Let's talk about it. Hi guys, this is me, Hardik. We are iGeeks Blog. Welcome to the channel. Today, we are gonna fix your problem of iPhone overheating. So when your iPhone overheats, we also need to understand that there is a reason behind it. There cannot be a smoke without a fire, right? So one of the most prime, main, and the basic reasons because of which your iPhone might be overheating would be a charging cable or a charging adapter. I cannot emphasize on this enough, and we have been always saying this, that make sure the cable and the charging dock which you use is either an original Apple product or MFI or PD certified. Now this I have been repeating for the longest period of time, seems like a very small little thing, but trust me, it all starts from here. A good cable and a good charging adapter. Secondly, if you are into cases, then make sure you use a good one. It should be either an Apple original product or a certified third-party vendor. The case quality is very important. The material that has been used, the fit that has been there, it is a very important thing for your phone. It might end up suffocating your phone. Hence, it will result in heating issues. So make sure a good case is out there with you. Apart from that, it goes without saying that when you're doing heavy stuff on your phone, like, you know, playing games or watching movies or navigating, then make sure you remove your cover and then continue your activity. Now, since we're on the topic of maps, I've often observed that many people keep their phones on the dashboard for navigation. Now, that way your phone is exposed to direct harsh sunlight that will result in overheating. And after, of course, navigating, we were also talking about playing games or watching movies on the phone. What you can do about that? Of course, you're gonna watch movies. Of course, you're gonna play games, but then you always face the overheating issues while doing this. In that case, try and use a low brightness mode. That way you can keep on doing your activity for a longer period of time, and it will also help you with the overheating issue. Now, in this case, we need to understand that an iPhone performs the best when it's kept between the temperatures of 0 degree to 35 degrees Celsius. Now, it's impossible in some tropical countries, but still we have to try. Now we need to check that which of our app is draining battery more than usual, as a result of which there is power consumption, and as a result of which there is heat generation. For that, you need to go to settings. From there, you need to go to battery, and over there you need to scroll down to see battery usage by app. Over here, you will see all the apps which are using your battery, and here you need to figure out if at all there is an app which is using your battery, draining your battery a lot, but you hardly use it. In that case, you need to uninstall that app as soon as possible, and you can try to reinstall it. If the problem persists, then you need to let go of that app permanently. Next, we need to keep the apps in check which are using your GPS for tracking your iPhone continuously. For that, we need to go into setting. From there, we'll go to privacy and security. Over there, we'll go to location services. Here you'll see the list of the apps which are using your location. You can individually go to each and every app and select the action which you want to take for the tracking of their location. Either you can allow them to check your location when you're using the app, and if at all that is not necessary, then you can select the option never. That way they won't be able to track your location. After that, when you scroll down, you'll see system services. Here, you'll see all the services offered by the system, which is continuously tracking you. And here, the purple arrow indicates that an item has recently used your location. Over here as well, you can go to each and every system service and decide for yourself if at all that particular service needs your tracking access or not. Next, I want to talk about network selection. Now, it seems like a very small little thing, but it keeps on continuously using a lot of resources from your phone. Just go to settings, from there go to mobile data, then tap on network selection. Here you will find automatic selection, but you need to turn the toggle off for this one. Once you turn the toggle off, you will get a list of networks and you can select the appropriate network which is right for you. Now let's understand, why is this setting very important? Let's say you leave your house every day and then you go to work. Same, you leave your work every day and then you go back to your home. This is the journey which you take every day. Now, from your home to your office, there are a lot of network towers in the journey. So what will your phone do? Your phone will be keep on looking for newest and the nearest network signal so that it can give you the best experience. So that way, your phone's resources would be used continuously and that might result in heating of the phone. But whenever you are traveling or you're going to a secluded place where you want your phone to look for network even when you are not looking, that is when you should turn on the auto mode. Otherwise, you should always select your network manually. Now, we have all heard that we should not keep on killing apps. And it makes sense, of course, RAM management, ease of use, etc. But excess of anything is bad. It's fatal. So when we talk about this, that means that if it is 5 to 10 apps which are open, so it's okay, multitasking, good stuff. But that doesn't mean that you never kill your apps and we have 50 tabs open. Doesn't make sense. It will just put extra burden on your phone, and as a result of which, it might also generate heat. Now, I know many people out there who have this habit to take their phone to the bed, and while scrolling, they prefer to sleep. But once they sleep, what they do is they tuck in their phone beneath the pillow. That way, the phone has no space to breathe. Don't do that. Keep your phone in an open environment where there is air, to breathe, there is space to live. Do that and it will help a lot with the overheating issue. We all get very excited, we get childlike when there is a beta update for our iPhones. But then what happens? We download that update and then we start on complaining that there are heating issues, there are bugs, this, that, everything. But then why to do it? Right? We should always wait for a stable version. In fact, I would say that wait for the reviews for a few days and then download the stable version. Lastly, all these things that I've told you about are majorly the reasons of overheating of your phone. But now, if you feel that your phone is overheated, now you want to know the solution, what to do about it. So firstly, if it overheats beyond a level, your iPhone will switch off automatically and will switch on automatically. So there is nothing we can do about it. But if that is not the case, your phone has just started heating up and you want to understand what to do about it, then what I would suggest is, stop. Precisely. You heard it right. Just stop whatever you're doing which is causing heating to your phone. If you're charging, stop the charging. If you're playing a game, stop that game. If you're using the phone under direct sunlight, make sure it is safe and not under direct sun. This way, you need to give your phone some space. We need to understand that there is no shortcut, no organic way to cool down your phone. We need to give it 30 to 60 minutes under room temperature in a normal temperature to cool off. I hope I was able to fix overheating issues of iPhone for you. And if at all you have any inputs, any suggestions that you want to make, don't forget to comment down below. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell icon. And of course, if you're doing all these things, you also need to go to your app store and download our IGB app to keep in touch with everything Apple. This is me, Hardik. We are iGeeks Blog. I'll see you next time. Till then, take care. God bless.